Well, good morning, everyone. A short time ago, I resigned as Shadow Attorney General and Shadow Minister for Indigenous Australians. It's clear that the Shadow Cabinet and the party room and I have taken a different position in relation to The Voice. I haven't been able to persuade them. With the referendum due later this year, I believe the time for The Voice has come, and I will support the referendum being put this year.
Julian Leeser has shown real strength today. He's put his principles ahead of partisan politics. He certainly knows this is a once-in-a-generation chance to make a real difference.
The Voice is not about special privileges. It's about recognising that Indigenous Australians are our brothers and sisters, and we have left them behind in our shared national project.
Thank you very much to Julian Leeser for his service to our party. He has gone through a process within our party, and his position is at odds with the overwhelming majority of the Liberal Party members in our party room.
Peter Dutton has underestimated the number of Liberal and National Party voters who will vote yes.
My resignation today as a frontbencher is not about personality. It's about trying to keep faith with the very cords of belief and belonging that are part of who I am.
Julian's position in this is pretty unique.
I believe that The Voice can help move the dial on Indigenous education, health, housing, safety and economic development. I believe better policy is made when the very people who are affected by it are consulted. I intend to campaign for a yes vote.
Former Shadow Attorney General Julian Leeser joins us now from Sydney. Julian, thanks for your time. Giving up the Shadow Attorney General job means a massive demotion for you. Just how hard was it to make this decision?
Look, I think it's important in politics that you stand for the things that you believe in. That's certainly what I want to tell my children I've been in politics for, to stand for some things that I believe in. I've been involved in the Voice issue since long before I became a parliamentarian. When Peter Dutton says my position is unique, he's right. I worked with constitutional conservatives and Indigenous people to try and find a way forward on constitutional recognition. And I think The Voice is a good idea because it provides for some practical outcomes, to consult the people, the Indigenous people that we make laws and policies about on the basis of them being Indigenous. Every Australian wants to see better outcomes for Indigenous people. We haven't been getting those outcomes. There's still a massive gap. I think The Voice can do some good, and I want to campaign yes for it. I don't just want to campaign yes for it today. I think there are some things that we can do to the model that's been put forward in order to enhance the number of Australians that will want to support it. And that's what I'll be doing between now and when the parliamentary committee that is due to make advice to the parliament about The Voice reports later in May.
You referenced that your position's unique. It's not just your position, it's your expertise. So you're obviously Shadow Attorney General until today. You're the Shadow Indigenous Affairs Minister. You spent almost 10 years working on The Voice proposal, as you mentioned there. You're also a constitutional lawyer. I mean, if the Liberal Party had to design a prototype to come up with Liberal Party policy on this, you would be it. Why didn't the party listen to you?
Well, one of the great things about the Liberal Party, unlike the Labor Party, is that we have a system where if you're a backbencher, you can speak out on different policy issues and campaign for the issues that you, as you see fit. We had a party room meeting. I've been engaging with my colleagues for many months. I'm trying to persuade them and listening to them and their concerns. And obviously I wasn't able to persuade them. And because this was an issue that's particularly important to me, that long predates my time in the parliament, that I regarded as important, I decided to resign my position as a frontbencher, to not be bound by the policy, to remain in the Liberal Party and to campaign for a yes vote. So, and that's what I intend to do.
Right, and I understand all that. I guess the bit I don't understand is, why weren't you persuasive to them? Like, if there's anybody that should hold authority in that room on an issue like this, it would be you, I would have thought. So what's actually going on there?
People come to this issue with a range of different life experiences. I mean, we have members of parliament that represent large Indigenous communities, and they're concerned about the fact that there's no guaranteed local and regional element to this voice. We've got Indigenous members of parliament who are concerned about the way in which this is structured and whether it will actually deal with the real problems on the ground. And we have people that are concerned about the constitutional issues in relation to this.
Now, Julian, the opposition says The Voice is tearing the country apart, but it seems to be tearing the Liberal Party apart. Why is it so divisive within your party?
Well, firstly, it's not tearing the Liberal Party apart. I mean, the view that was expressed in relation to the policy that the Liberal Party took was the overwhelming view of colleagues. I just have a different view on this. It's a view that's also shared by the Tasmanian Liberal Premier and was shared by the former New South Wales Liberal Premier. We are a broad church. It's a real strength of the Liberal Party that we're a broad church.
But Julian, you don't see resignations from Shadow Cabinet every day, and you don't see former Indigenous Affairs Ministers who are themselves Indigenous quit the party, even if they're no longer in Parliament. You don't see that every day. That looks like something splitting at the seams here. It doesn't look like something that you downplay.
Well, I can tell you from the inside it's not that at all, and I'm not downplaying it. I've reached out to Ken Wyatt. I very much want him to come back. He's been an important mentor and friend to me. And the only reason I've left is because... And I haven't left the party and I haven't left the caucus. And I want to be very clear. I want to see Peter Dutton as the next Prime Minister, and I will be working hard to ensure that. I just have a disagreement and a difference of view on one issue. And the great strength of the Liberal Party, unlike the Labor Party, is that you can still be a member of the party room on the backbench and campaign for an issue that is different to party policy. That's a strength of our party. It's what makes it unique, and I'm really proud to be part of our party.
Doesn't this show, though, that Peter Dutton got it wrong in not allowing a full conscience vote, as we've seen in previous referendums?
Look, there's only one precedent for a conscience vote, and that's the Republic referendum. Yep. And as I say, the view was overwhelming in terms of the support of the position that the coalition's taken. My position is unique in relation to
this. Wouldn't have cost anything, right? Well, but now, by not having the conscience vote, it's cost them the Shadow Attorney General.
Well, that was a decision for me based on my own history in this debate. And I felt that I needed to be able to be free to campaign for this. That's a unique position I have based on the history that I have in this debate. And I wanted to be true to my values, and I wanted to keep faith with the Indigenous leaders that I'd worked with. I wanted to keep faith with people in my community. I wanted to keep faith with my view of the Constitution. And I wanted to show to my children that it's important to stand up for the things that you believe in, even when it costs you.
OK, Julian, you said you'll be campaigning for a yes vote. Give us your best pitch.
Look, I think The Voice can make a real difference to people on the ground because I think you make better policy and laws when you consult people who are affected by those policies and laws about them before you make them. You get a better outcome, you get more buy-in, you get better bang for your buck, and we have to shift the dial on Indigenous disadvantage in this country, and I think The Voice will make a real difference.
Sounds pretty impressive to us. Julian, thanks so much for your time tonight.
Thanks very much.